So, vertical video. It's a bit of a touchy subject, but let's face it, it's not going anywhere. No matter how much you try to avoid it, sooner or later, you will have to edit a vertical video. The problem is, Final Cut Pro kind of sucks for editing vertical videos. The titles get cropped off, transitions look a little wonky, it's a mess. Final Cut Pro was meant for editing conventional 16:9 videos, and most titles, effects, and transitions were designed for 16:9 timelines. Now, a lot of them work just fine in a vertical timeline, but not all. My friend Dylan Bates has made a plugin that lets you edit vertical videos in a horizontal timeline. This way, you can use every effect included in Final Cut Pro. And I do know how weird this sounds, editing vertical video in horizontal timelines, but let me just show you. First thing you want to do is make a new project and set your frame rate and resolution. Set the resolution of this project to either 4K or one of the lower conventional resolutions. Don't choose vertical or square here, this defeats the whole purpose. This will be the final resolution of your vertical video, so if you want to export a 4K video, choose 4K for your project. Now, when you add a vertical clip to your timeline, just like you would expect, you get vertical bars on the sides. If you add a conventional clip, it fills out your full frame. We'll have to crop these. Next, go to your Titles and Generators browser and select FCB's Pro Vertical plugin. Grab the Social Guides adjustment layer and add this above your timeline. Make sure it stretches out over your entire project. This does a few things. First, it highlights the part of your frame that'll be visible in your export. You can still see the rest of your clip, it's just dimmed out. This is really helpful when reframing your clips. Second, on the sides, you get these yellow lines marking save zones. A lot of the time, the aspect ratio of your phone isn't exactly 9:16, so your phone automatically zooms in on your video to fill out the screen. These safe zones show you what part of your frame might get cropped off, so make sure you don't have anything important outside these lines. You also get a square preview safe zone you can turn on in the inspector. This is for platforms like Twitter that only show you a square thumbnail and you don't get to see the full video unless you click on it. Something to keep in mind when framing your video. All these safe zone markers are fully customizable. You can change the color, opacity, outside zone opacity, or you can completely turn these off if you don't like them there. And last, you get user interface elements of a number of different social media platforms. This is also here to help you frame your shot, so you don't have something important covered up by the UI elements. This plugin includes UI elements of most of the popular platforms, at least in North America. You get YouTube, Instagram Reels, Instagram Stories, TikTok, Facebook, and more. These are just here to help you with framing your clip, and unless you want to, these will not show up in your export. There's also a few sharpening controls here, just in case your clip is a little blurry. Maybe you had to zoom in a bit to reframe it, and it's not as sharp as you'd like. Now, this is how you'd edit your entire video. Make sure your social guides adjustment layer is at the top, and use any title, effect, or transition included in Final Cut Pro. All these should work just as designed, because you are editing a conventional 16:9 project. Now, here's the genius of this plugin. When it comes time to export your project, make sure your adjustment layer is selected, and in the inspector window, all the way at the bottom, you have a prepared for export dropdown. Here, you can select just to turn off the user interface elements, or if you want to export your project without the black bars on the side and use the full resolution of your project, select No UI and Rotate. This takes a highlighted part of your frame and rotates it 90 degrees to utilize the entire resolution of your project. After you export your clip, there's just one more step. Because you exported a conventional 16:9 project, when you play it back, it will be sideways. To fix this, simply select your clip and press Command R to rotate your clip 90 degrees. Your video is ready to upload to the platform of your choice. Let's take a look at what else you get with this plugin. There's actually a lot. First, you get 4 dynamic backgrounds specifically designed for vertical video. These are really cool and fully adjustable. My favorite is the animated paper texture. Next, you get 4 basic animated shapes, and these are way better than Final Cut Pro's built-in shape generators. You can resize these, move them around, rotate them, change color, and if you don't like the in or out animations, you have the option to turn these completely off. Under this, you get 2 subtitle presets. Now, these aren't automated captions, it's all manual, but still, really cool. You add these above your timeline, add your own text, and use keyframes to animate it to match the audio in your clip.
Like and subscribe for more cool adventures.
And just like everything else in this plugin, these are fully adjustable. And last in the titles category, three zoom and pan presets. If you're familiar with Dylan's Pro Zooms plugin, you know exactly how useful these are. You add these above your timeline and use the on-screen controls to select what part of the frame you want to zoom into. This looks so much better than using the transform tool. We're not done yet. With FCB's Pro Vertical plugin, you also get 13 transitions and 9 effects designed specifically for vertical video. My favorites here are split screen effects, and the way Dylan built these is genius. See, most split screen effects or plugins use drop zones. Drop zones are okay, but Final Cut Pro sucks for drop zones, especially with audio. With this plugin, there is no drop zones. You just layer your clips in the timeline and add the same effect to all three clips. Now, in the inspector window, you select where each clip goes. Let's put one on top, one in the middle, and one on the bottom. Also, let's make our middle clip come in from the right. This is a super easy way to do split screens, and each clip retains its audio. You can play back audio from all three, or select a specific clip for the audio and turn the volume down in the others. Genius. If you make vertical videos, or plan to make any in the future, which you probably should, you'll need this plugin. I'll link it down below. Also, for the two people here watching that don't know who Dylan Bates is, I'll also link his channel below. Go check it out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.